Welcome to CareSmarts 360 On Air, a home care podcast. I'm Erin Kell, account executive at CareSmarts 360. I'm thrilled to have with us Sheila Davis, the senior executive vice president of operations at Always Best Care Senior Services. Sheila is an accomplished healthcare administration expert with a wealth of experience in directing successful operational strategies and driving academic and research facility initiatives. Sheila's background is truly impressive. She has spent extensive years overseeing healthcare operations, spearheading financial reporting and management, budgeting, staff recruitment, revenue generation, and service line expansion. Her expertise in these areas has been instrumental in helping organizations thrive and deliver exceptional care to their communities. Today, we'll be diving into Sheila's insights on the evolving landscape of senior care, the challenges and opportunities facing healthcare leaders, and the innovative approaches she's championing to ensure the best possible outcomes for clients and their families. This is sure to be a fascinating conversation, so let's get started. Welcome to the podcast, Sheila.
Thank you. Appreciate it very much.
So we'll jump right into it. As a senior care franchise spread across multiple locations, what are some of the key regulatory and compliance challenges you face in maintaining consistent quality and safety standards?
Sure. So, you know, operating a senior care franchise across multiple locations, as you stated, presents itself significant regulatory and compliance challenges, particularly to ensure consistent adherence to all the rules and regulations on the local, state, and federal level. These vary from licensing requirements to labor laws, patient privacy acts, which everybody is, you know, knows as HIPAA. And meeting safety standards across all the locations. It's a day-to-day balancing act. I think a lot of people think that home care agencies are regulated by the state and don't understand all the other aspects of regulatory bodies that also oversee them. So, you know, maintaining consistency in care delivery and meeting those safety standards across, you know, the locations while navigating the different fireworks that come at you day-to-day is really challenging. But, you know, ensuring compliance with all of those evolving regulations in areas such as elder abuse, prevention, medication management, infection control requires constant vigilance and adaptation. And we're just constantly trying to adapt new technologies. There's all kinds of new AI adaptive tools that are coming out in our software platforms that are helping with those aspects of it. So I think that technology is really the one that is going to play a real big presence in our key regulatory and compliance challenges going forward to help us meet those challenges in compliance.
Mm-hmm. And how do you approach staff training and development to ensure all caregivers, regardless of location, are delivering the same high level of personalized, compassionate care?
We've implemented a standardized training across our platform, to all of our franchise locations, not only for our caregiver staff, but for our back office staff too. This includes a combination of in-person and online and ongoing refresher courses focused on core competencies to ensure that our client safety is always up the upfront most important aspect of our care. We deal with patient safety, we deal with dementia care, communication issues and barriers every day. So making sure that that training is there for our caregivers and our staff also. That's a lot of times too, what people mistakenly think is that, you know, there's just that caregiver obstacle that you have to overcome, that's the only one that the patient and the patient's family is ever going to be communicating with. But they're also communicating with that back office staff as well on scheduling purposes, if there's a billing issue. So, you know, there's those communication and technologies that you have to also train your back office staff as well as your caregiver staff. We emphasize that importance of empathy as well. My motto has always been, you don't want to take care of someone if it wasn't your own family member. And that's kind of the motto that our franchise system stands behind. We also want to ensure that our teachings and our knowledge are compliance and regulatory specific. So it's what the industry is wanting teaching on and what we feel like our caregivers are needing teaching on. We use a learning management system to track our learning and our knowledge base of our caregivers so that we ensure that they're getting the adequate number of hours per year. And we're also always open to any caregiver or employee who comes to us and asks us for more knowledge and training to afford that opportunity to them.
That's great. What strategies have you found effective in fostering a culture of excellence and accountability across your franchise network? And how do you empower local franchise owners to uphold your brand values?
You know, we encourage local franchise owners to embody those values and lead by example. To empower them, we provide tools and resources like leadership training, operational support, performance metrics that help them monitor and assess their quality of care, regular meetings and performance reviews, and sharing best practices across the network helps reinforce accountability. So, you know, encouraging that open communication, those feedback loops, and recognizing that outstanding performance, which promotes a sense of ownership and accountability at the local level. We really do empower our franchisees to, you know, they are independently owned offices and operations. And so we want them to feel empowered to operate in such a manner, but consistent with the brand standards as well. So really empowering them.
Right. And managing finances and budgets can be complex for multi-site operations. What best practices have you implemented to maintain financial oversight and transparency throughout your franchise system?
We use a centralized financial management system software that allows for real-time monitoring of key financial metrics. Our EMR, our platform that houses all of our key metrics for our clients as well. So we're able to utilize and see what those KPIs are and measure those against our financials. You know, really, we use key financial metrics, including revenue, expenses, payroll, budgeting for each location, best practices, including, you know, our standardized financial chart of accounts. We also have a set of performance groups that is based on really looking at those financial metrics and those KPIs, and those groups kind of form their own board of directors, per se, because some of our franchise locations are only owned by an independent or maybe a couple. And sometimes it's real hard to hold yourself accountable for your own finances, you know? I mean, and sometimes you get too involved in the day-to-day operations to really think about that. So we formed some performance groups. We have, like I said, five or six in our system that encompasses about 80% of our franchises. And they get together four times a year. They, like I said, they're their own board of directors. They hold each other accountable for their metrics and their KPIs. They share their information with each other. And so we've seen just little bitty wins, you know, that maybe somebody is having more overtime hours than their peer is over here. And so they'll share ideas on how to cut back on that overtime hour, or maybe it's the cost of their office space is a little bit more expensive than that of their peers. So how do they adjust that? And by seeing those little bit of adjustments, we've seen some really good financial wins and aspects come out. Of course, you know, we encourage all of our owners to do a what is your bottom line, knowing what your metrics are, knowing what your cost of service is, and knowing what your out-of-pocket owner's discretionary profit is. That's what they're all in the business for. So, and what is their break-even analysis? So we really go over those metrics and those worksheets and teaching them how to calculate those things on a monthly and quarterly basis, and then bringing them together to share with their peers and to help them hold each other accountable and make changes.
Well, that's great. Yeah. Technology plays a critical role in home care today. How do you leverage digital tools and platforms to streamline operations, enhance caregiver coordination, and improve client outcomes across your locations?
We really use our electronic health record, our EMR or EHR, to ensure accurate, up-to-date information. We use the WellSky platform, and they are very good about customizing reports, customizing KPIs, but we really look for that up-to-date client information to be shared seamlessly among caregivers. We think that the more the caregivers know, the better outcomes and the better patient care that can be given. Scheduling and workforce management platforms help to efficiently assign shifts in scheduling and make sure that care is delivered across the platform. We also use telehealth services and mobile apps for real-time communication with caregivers, and then enabling families and quick adjustments to some of those shifts. We also have a digital solution. We've introduced some AI technology this year to improve caregiver coordination and patient outcomes. We feel like that, you know, anything that we can do to help the client, sometimes they can't afford 24-hour care, but maybe they can afford 4 or 5 hours of care, and we can put telehealth, or we can put an assistive AI device in the home, and it is showing that there are better outcomes for those clients to assure their safety and to allow them to age in place, which is where they want to be, is in their home.
And my last question for you, Sheila, recruiting and retaining quality caregivers is an ongoing challenge in the home care industry. What innovative approaches have you taken to build a strong, stable workforce that delivers exceptional service?
You know, I wish I had a secret sauce to share with everybody right here, because I think this is, you know, the number one issue across the spectrum
very
right now.
Tough.
But, you know, it's very tough. And I don't think any of us in any franchise system or any individual office has actually developed what that secret sauce is. But it's really offering those competitive wages, flexible schedules, opportunities for career advancement that really helps retain and attain and retain attention. And so we've implemented those. We have a caregiver rewards program that we have. So that's in place. It's very easy. It's through our EMR system as well. So that reward system has really helped with recruitment and retention. We also emphasize employee recognition and engagement programs. We feel like that those foster loyalty and helps reduce turnovers. And, you know, really to address the recruitment challenges, we've partnered with local training programs and schools. We've offered some internships and scholarships, which have attracted new caregivers. And additionally, we've implemented some referral bonuses, which have been proven to be very effective. So it's all the things that everybody out there is doing. It's just hopefully that we're doing it in a little bit more streamlined. And of course, the continuing education. I think that that's one of the things that, in my personal opinion, is so often overlooked. The first thing that people mainly think about is that caregivers are so focused on wages, and it's that quarter of an hour here or 50 cents of an hour over there that really drives them. But caregivers, they want to do a good job. They want to be acknowledged. They want to know that they're part of a system, and they want to continue learning. They're like the rest of us. They want to learn. So providing that continuing education and allowing for additional education when they request it has really helped our retention efforts here.
Yeah, no, that's great. Well, thank you so much, Sheila, for sharing your expertise.
Absolutely.
I know it's really valuable. And to our lovely audience, thank you for tuning in. Until next time, I'm Erin Kell, signing off.